Assalamu alaikum. Dear students, hope you are fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Welcome to NIBS Homeschool. This is Muhammad Imdadul Haq, Assistant Teacher of Mathematics, National Ideal English Version School, Day Shift. Dear students, today we are going to start the class for annual examination. This is the first class for you. Okay, our today's I'll take a math class of class 5 now. Our today's topic is chapter 9, percentage, page 94 and 95, and exercise 9, question 3. I'll solve now, and some HW also given for you. Okay, dear students, let us start. Our today's topic is percentage. At first, we have to know what is percentage. So, the definition of percentage you have to know at first. See here, a ratio expressed as a fraction of 100 is called percentage. It means that if we observe here, 10 is a number and 100 is also another number. If we take a ratio, means a fraction, 10 by 100, if we consider this, here the denominator is 100. If the denominator of a fraction is 100, then we can say here this is 10%. This symbol is known as the percentage symbol. This symbol is known as the percentage symbol. Dear students, if we write 1%, it will be 1 of 100, 1 of 100. So we can say the value of percentage means is 1 by 100, 1 by 100. Now observe here, per means every, cent means 100. It means that the portion we consider in every 100 is known as percentage. Suppose 5 by 100, here we are taking 5 from 100. This is known as 5%. This is known as 5%. 5%. It means that the portion we consider in every 100 is known as percentage. Now I'll show how to express some fractions or decimal numbers into percentage. See here, 21 by 50 is a fraction. We can convert this fraction into percentage. To convert this fraction into percentage means we have to convert the denominator into 100. It means that if we multiply both the numerator and denominator by 2, this will be 42 by 100. And this we can write 42%, as the denominator is 100. If the denominator of a fraction is 100, then we can say the numerator in percentage. Okay, now observe this one. Here we have used a technique we have multiplied both the numerators and denominators by the same number to convert the denominator into 100. But in this case, we can't convert 15 into 100. Now, how can we convert this one into percentage? For this, we can apply two techniques. I'll show you two techniques. First one is, we'll multiply both the numerators and denominators by 100. As our denominator should be 100, so the 100 in denominator will remain same. Just we'll calculate the number except 100 which is in the denominator and the numbers in the above portion. If we divide 15 by 5, we'll get 3. If we divide 100 by 5, we'll get 20. So we can divide 12 by 3, this will be 4. So we can say this should be 80 by 100. Now we can write this 80% as the denominator is 100 here, as the denominator is 100 here. We can convert this fraction into percentage is in another way also. Let us see the process. 12 by 15. We can multiply the numerator only by 100 and divide by the denominator, and using bracket we have to use the percentage sign. In this way also we can convert a general fraction into percentage. Now see, we can divide 12 by 3, it will be 4. We can divide 15 by 3, it will be 5. Now divide 100 by 5, it will be 20. So we can say 80, and here is percentage sign. So we can write this is 80%. You can apply any technique among these three techniques. First one is, you have to convert the denominator into 100 multiplying by any number. But in every case, it will not be easy for you. For this, you can apply another two methods. These two methods, you can convert any fraction into percentage easily using these two methods. In the third method, last method, you have to remember that don't forget to give this percentage sign. Don't forget to give this percentage sign. Now I'll show how can we convert a decimal fraction into percentage. At first, convert the decimal fraction into general fraction. To convert the decimal fraction into general fraction, we have to write the number except the decimal in the numerator. Then we have to observe here is decimal. For this we have to write 1 in denominator. Then we have to put 0, counting the digit after the decimal. As here is only 1 digit, so we have to give only 1 0. Now we have converted this decimal fraction into general fraction. Now easily we can convert this into percentage. We can apply any technique here. I have shown you 3. Multiply both the numerators and denominators by 10, you will get 30 by 100. So we can say this means 30%. This means 30%. Now I'll show expressed into general fraction and decimal fraction. How can we convert the fractions into general fraction and decimal fraction? How can we convert percentage into general fraction and decimal fraction? As here is percentage sign, to remove this percentage sign, we have to take 100 in denominator and the number will be in the numerator. This is the general fraction, but we can convert this into lowest term. We can convert this into lowest term. If we convert this into lowest term, then this will be, we can divide both by 2. This will be 50 and this will be 17. We can write here 17 by 50. So this is the general fraction of the given percentage. Now I want to convert this one into decimal. 34% means 34 by 100 at first. It's very easy to convert this fraction into decimal. As denominator is 100, we know a technique. 34 means 34.00. In this way we can write. As the denominator is 100, it means we have to divide 34 by 100. If we divide a number, a decimal number by 10, 100, this type of number, just decimal will move to the left. As here is 20, decimal will move 2 digit left. So it will be, decimal will be before 3. So it will be 0.34. Now I'll show another number. 125% convert this one into general fraction, 125 by 100. Now we can take it in lowest term. We can divide by 25. This will be 5, this will be 4. This means 5 by 4, as this is improper fraction, so we can convert this into mixed. So this will be our general fraction. If we convert this into decimal, this will be 125 by 100 means 1.25 if we convert this into decimal. Now I'll solve 3 questions here, fill in the blanks. Let us see the questions. First one, 25 liters are dash percent of 50 liters. It means that we have to convert the ratio of 25 and 50 into percentage. See here, the ratio of 25 and 50. If we want to convert, we can convert easily here. 25 multiply by 2, 50 multiply by 2, this will be 50 by 100. It means that 50%. So our first one answer is 50%. Answer is 50%. Second one, dash kilograms are 20% of 120. It means we have to take 20% of 120. So we can write 20% of 120 gram. It means that 20% means 20 by 100 of means multiplication. If we divide 100 by 20, we'll get 5 here. Now we can divide 120 by 5. If we divide, we'll get 2 times 10, 2 left 20, then 5 fourths are 20. It means 24. It means that 24 gram. So our required answer for question 2 is 24 kilogram, not gram this one, kilogram. Okay, now let us see question 3. 16 people are 32% of dash people. It means we have to find the total number of people. Here 30% of total number of people is 16. It means that 30% is equal to 16. Total people means 100% people. It means that 32% is equal to 16. People, 1%. So we have to divide 16 by 32 people. Then 100% means total people. 100% of anything means the total. So we have to multiply 16 by 32 into 100. Now we can cut by 16. This will be 2. We can cut here, this will be 50. So we can say 50 people are the 32% of 16 people are the 32% of 50 people. 16 people are the 32% of 50 people. Now I'll solve two questions. Let us see the first question. The population of Shakhipur village is 1280, and 40% of the population of that village is educated. Find the number of educated person. To find the number of educated person, we have to take 40% of the total population. So you can write, given total population is 1280. 40% of them are educated. Therefore, the number of educated person will be equal to 40% of the total population, 1280. So 40% means 40 by 100, of means multiplication, 1280. Now we can calculate here. It means that we are dividing both the numerator and denominator by 20. Now we can divide 1280 by 5. If we divide here, see, 5 1 2 8 0. Now 2 times 10, 2 left. Now 5 times, this is 25. Now 3 left, take 0, 30. 6 times, now this is 30. So we can say 256. If we multiply 256 and 2, this will be 5, 6, 2, 12, and 2, 5, 10, and 1, 11, 2, 2, 4, and 1, 5. It means that 512 people. It means that number of educated persons, persons is 512. This is our required answer for this question, 512 persons. Now I'll go to the next question. What is the next question? The next question is, Hussain's monthly income is 2500 taka and he spends 1750 taka on food. Shamim's monthly income is 1800 taka and he spends 1440 taka on food. Express the ratio of expense on food to the total income in percent. It means that we have to express the ratio on food to the total income in percentage. Next question is, who spends more portion on food? It means that we have to find out the person who spends more portion on food. Solution. First one. Here the ratio of expense on food to the total income. Total income of Hussain is, what will be the ratio? As we have written expense at first, so we have to write expense in denominator, 1750 taka, and we have to write the total income in the, we have to write the expense in the numerator and we have to write the total income in the denominator, 2500 taka. Now we have to convert this fraction into percentage. 1750 divided by 2500. We can convert easily. 1750 multiply by 100, 2500 multiply by 100. This 100 will remain same. Now we have to calculate here. If we divide by 100, it will be 25. Now cut by 25, you will get 70. If you divide 1750 by 25, you will get 70. So we can say 70 by 100, it means that 70%. It means Hussain spent 70%, therefore Hussain spends 70% on food. Again, the ratio of expense on food to the total income of Shamim is, what will be the ratio? As expense I have written first, so we have to write expense in numerator and we have to write the total income in denominator. Now we have to convert this fraction into percentage. 1440 multiply by 100. 1800 multiply by 100. Now this 100 will remain same, so we can calculate here. We can cut by 100, it will be 18. If we divide this by 18, it will be 80. Now we can say 80 by 100, so we can say 80%. It means that Shamim spends 80% on food. Shamim spends 80% on food. This is our first question. Let us solve the second question. Who spends more portion on food? From one, we get Hussain spends 70% of his income on food, and Shamim spends 80% of his income on food. Here 80 is greater than 70, therefore as 80 for Shamim, we can say Shamim spends more portion on food. Shamim spends more portion on food. So our answer for 2 is Shamim. Dear students, you have some homework for today. See your homework. I have given your homework from exercise 9, activity 1 and activity 2. This type of question I have solved in this class, and This one is also a very simple question. You can solve this easily. Though this as HW in your assigned HW copy. The students remember this HW is very important for you as CT marks and diary marks of annual exam will be given based on your HW. I hope all of you have understood today's topic. Keep practicing at home, abide by your parents, stay safe. Thank you all.